ಅನುದಿನ ಅನುಕ್ಷಣ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲೂ ಕಲಿಯೋಣ ಕಲಿಕೆಯ ಹೊಸ ಹಾದಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಜೊತೆಗೂಡಿ ಹೆಜ್ಜೆಯ ಹಾಕೋಣ ಸಂತಸದಿ ಕಲಿಯೋಣ ನಮ್ಮ ಹೆಮ್ಮೆಯ ಈ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿನಲ್ಲಿ
ಎಸ್
ಎಸ್ ಟೀಚರ್ ಕಸನ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್
Hi, hello, namaste everyone. How are you all? Hope all are fine and happy at home. That's good. Let me welcome you all to this English class, standard 8. And today, we will be discussing about the second lesson in your textbook, that is sandalwood trees. Yes, my dear students, are you all ready? Yes, that's great. Then why to waste the time? Come on, take your textbook, pen, pencil, notepad and all your writing materials. Let's begin our today's session with second lesson, that is sandalwood trees. Shall we everyone? Are you all ready? That's great. So before begin my session, let me tell you about the importance of nature. I want you to observe this particular slide, and this slide is about the importance of nature. It says like this: if you truly love nature, if you truly love nature, you will find beauty everywhere. Yes, my dear students, nature is the beauty. Nature is green, nature is blue. Above all, nature is you and nature is me. Yes, my dear students, try to understand, if you truly love nature, you will find beauty everywhere. Nature always weighs the colors or the spirit. Look deep into the nature and then you will understand everything better. Yes, in order to understand everything better, my dear students, try to understand the importance of this nature. On that note, let me tell you, Mother Earth has blessed us. Mother Earth has blessed us countless things, such as air, water, plants, fruits, so many available natural resources. But we, her children, are not at all treating well. So on that note, now I just want you people to observe the next pictures. See, here I have given here, look at the pictures, but now let me tell you, observe the pictures. My dear students, looking at something or seeing something is different, but now I want you people to observe. Try to observe the pictures over here and ask a question to yourself. What is the question? What happens if trees are cut? Yes, my dear students, please try to understand and try to observe these pictures. What happens if trees are cut down? Yes, this is the first picture. Second one, just observe. And the third one, yes. And the fourth one, just look at these particular trees. And all together, now I want you to observe the pictures. My dear students, just observe, if we human beings are indiscriminately cutting down the trees for our selfish needs, if the things goes on like this, just try to understand what's going to happen tomorrow. What will be the situation tomorrow, my dear students? Just observe these four pictures, how indiscriminately the human beings are cutting down the trees. So altogether, what we can able to say? So altogether we can say, or put it under one particular definition, saying that this comes under the category of deforestation. What is this? Deforestation. So on that note, let us watch a small video about a deforestation and then we'll come back. Thank you. Have you observed the video, everyone? Yes, my dear students, it's the question of observation, not only just looking at the video or not just seeing the video. I told you before, my dear students, you have to observe the difference and what exactly we need to learn. Yes, now I request you to open your textbook, page number 8, there is a pre-reading activity, and in that one, the first word itself is about deforestation, my dear students. Yes, now it's a question for you to understand what exactly the word deforestation is all about. Shall we see the definition, my dear students? Yes? Yes, now then take out your textbook, see page number 8, the first word that is about deforestation. It means deforestation is when forests are destroyed by cutting trees and not replanting them. Yes, that last three words are very important. Of course, we are cutting down the trees. Of course, we are destroying the forest like anything. But we are not replanting them. That is the word we need to observe. At the same time, what are the causes for this deforestation? What is the reason? What is the cause? Just see the first one. Trees are cut down for agricultural purposes. And trees are cut down for cultivation of crops. Because for the increasing population, yes, at the same time, deforestation is happening because of grazing, because of firewood, because for the construction of buildings. Yes, my dear students, nowadays we are all observing and come across many of the agriculture lands have been converted as a non-agriculture land, especially for the sake of construction of buildings. Am I right? Yes, you too have observed those things. Above all, observe the last point. Because of the deforestation, it is destroying the habitation of the many animals and birds. Yes, many animals and birds have lost their place, their habitation because of this deforestation, my dear students. Then, what next? What we are supposed to do now? The biggest question mark, and where is the answer? Shall we find an answer? Are you all ready? If so, come on. Let us observe this particular slide and let us take a promise. Let us take an oath. Shall we? Are you all ready? If so, come on. Get up and stretch your arm and make a promise. We, the younger generation, has to make a promise. Yes, this is the promise that I am going to take. Shall we take the promise, everyone? Are you all ready? Fine then. Let us repeat after me. See if this particular slide. Always keep a green tree in your heart. Always keep a green tree in your heart so that the flying birds will come to you automatically. How wonderful, na? How nice. When you have a green tree in your heart, then you won't have nasty thoughts. So flying birds will come to you automatically, then everything will be green and everything will be pleasant. So on that note, I request you to stand up, please, and stretch your arm. Let us take an oath. Shall we take an oath? Shall we make a promise? Yes, of course, we have to make a promise, my dear students, because after watching this video, after observing all these, pictures, we, the younger generation, has to take a promise. Yes, come on, let's take an oath. First one, don't destroy the greenery. Yes, repeat after me. Don't destroy the greenery and don't spoil the scenery. Don't destroy the greenery and don't spoil the scenery. Second one. Yes, come on, stretch your arm, stretch your hand. Plant a tree so that next generation can get air for free, air for free. How nice it is. The next generation is you and we people, yes. Plant a tree so that next generation can get air for free. The next one, my dear students, try to observe and understand. Don't make trees rare. Don't make trees rare. We should keep them with care. Yes. And the last one, let us promise. Save the trees, save the earth. Repeat after me. save the trees, save the earth. Will you all follow this one? That's great, my dear students. On that note, let us go to the lesson. Let me tell you once again, open your textbook, page number 8, second lesson, sandalwood trees. My dear students, today we are going to discuss about sandalwood trees. Yes, before going to the lesson, let us see the glossary words. First one, to tend, that means to take care of. Second one, explosion. What is that? Something blowing up or bursting out. That is what the word. Third one, landslide. Landslide means a natural fall of earth in hill and mountain ranges. Fourth one, denudation, making something bare or strip off. Fifth one, stump. That means a bottom part of a tree, that is cut tree, fixed to the ground. Sixth one, evidence, something that supports or proves a statement. And the seventh one, racket, a dishonest way of making money. This word is very interesting. And the next one is haunt, a place that creates feeling of worry or fear that you cannot easily overcome. My dear students, just observe these particular glossary in your page number, in your textbook page number 12. So once we go to the lesson, you will understand where exactly these words have used and what exactly the meaning of these words says that. Okay, on that note, let us go to the lesson in page number 8. Before I said page number 12, all the glossary words. Now come back, turn the page, come to page number 8, lesson number 2, sandalwood trees. Let us begin the first paragraph. Are you all ready? Yes. Before that, let me tell you, this particular lesson, sandalwood trees, is a wonderful story about a girl by name Sunanda. Yes, she was a brave girl. How did you come to know that she is a brave girl? Let us see the story now. The very interesting part of the story is that because of one particular incident that she has lost her eyesight, then also she has stood against the cutting down of trees. As we see the lesson, we'll come to know about it. Let us see the first paragraph. Yes, observe as I told you before. Yes, the first paragraph says like this. My parents and I lived near Karimunai village. See the word there. K-A-R-I-M-U-N-A-I. My parents and I lived near Karimunai village in the Eastern Ghats. Children, you might be familiar with the Eastern Ghats, Western Ghats, Northern Plains. No, all these. I think we are familiar with these things. So here the story goes like this. This particular story is a wonderful story about a girl by name called Sunanda. She used to live with her parents in a village called Karimunai village, that is in the Eastern Ghats. Her father owned a piece of a land on the hill slopes, and her mother used to look after the goats, and of course she is also used to help her mother. That is the meaning of the paragraph there. My parents and I lived near Karimunai village in the Eastern Ghats. My father owned a piece of land on the hill slopes, and my mother tended our goats and I helped them. Hope you understood the meaning. You got the point there? Yes. Now, I also studied in the village school. The word I refers to whom here? Yes, the story speaks about the girl by name called Sunanda. That's good. Remember that one. Sunanda also studied in a village school, and you know who is her companion, who is her very close friend? Yes, the Gugu the dog. Gugu the dog was her very close companion. She used to go to a village school and she used to study, and she used to live very happily with her parents. Now, one fine day, there was a terrible thing happened. What is the terrible thing? Yes. When she was at about 13 age, the day I was 13, if you just observe the word there, when she attained the age of 13, a terrible thing happened. That was, well, after sunrise, her parents heard a low rumbling sound. Of course, the goats and the Gugu felt very uneasy. What is that? There was a big explosion. If you just observe this particular picture, you can make out there was a big explosion. So what happened after the explosion? Because of the explosion, a stone hit her head, and when she opened her eyes, it was completely dark. That means the girl Sunanda has lost her eyes. The girl Sunanda has lost her eyes. Not only her eyes, my students, she has also lost her parents, even the goats. Only she was left out with a companion, that is Gugu. That is what the terrible thing that has happened. Then what happened afterwards? Just see this picture. After that incident, Rav Garu, observe the word there, Rav Garu, the headmaster of the village, had brought me to his house. The word me refers to the girl Sunanda. Yes, after that incident, what is that incident? As I said that it was a big explosion. Because of the explosion, a stone hit her head and she lost her eyesight. At the same time, even she lost everyone. Even she has lost her parents, even other things too. Now, Rav Garu, the headmaster of the village, had brought her to his house. And she used to call Rav Garu as Mama and wife as Mami. See that. My parents and the goats had been killed in the landslide, and he and his wife, whom I used to call as Mama and Mami, were very good to me. So what happened next to the life of Sunanda over there is the question. Of course, she has lost her parents. She lost other things too. Now she was with her dog, that is Gugu, the companion. Now she started living with the Rav Garu, the headmaster of the village. What happened afterwards? Just observe the paragraph over there. Of course, she was missing her parents a lot. Obviously, just imagine your life without parents. It's truly horrible, right? True. She used to miss her parents, and she said one particular word. See there, observe. My world was completely dark. If you just observe the picture there, her world has become completely dark. But Gugu was her great comfort. Gugu, the dog, was her great comfort and companion. And at that point of time, the headmaster of the village, Rav Garu, wanted to send her back to the school. Yes, Rav Garu wanted to send her back to school, but she used to refuse to go. Because she began to use to her own dark world. She was under great depression. She don't want to come outside. She don't want to go to school. So that was the situation of a girl, Sunanda. Hope you have understood up to here. Let's go to the next paragraph. So one fine day, Sunanda asked the headmaster of the village, that is Rav Garu, asking that, "Uncle, why do landslides occur?" She asked the question, "Uncle, tell me, why do landslides occur?" Now the answer is, "Man has started spoiling the nature thoughtlessly." This is what I said in the beginning of my session. The man, the human being, spoiling the nature thoughtlessly. So what happened over there? He explained, he is denuding the hillsides. By how? By cutting down the trees. Trees are actually helped to keep the mountain mass together. See this particular line, everyone, and underline in your textbook too. What is that? The trees actually help to keep the mountain mass together without them any stray disturbances. Without any stray disturbances. Under the earth's surface causes chunks of the land to slide down. If these trees have been cut something like this, if you just observe the picture, just see there, when the trees have been cut down, that land mass, that mountain mass will not be together, and when there is a heavy rainfall, automatically there will be a landslide. Hope you have understood the meaning there. The particular word is mountain mass. If the trees were there everywhere, that mountain mass will be together. When we are indiscriminately cutting down the trees like this, then what will happen to the mountain mass over there? Obviously, due to the heavy rainfall, there will be landslides. So that is what happened. Now, Sunanda has come to understood that denudation, trees are cut down legally for the various reasons. Of course, there are many legal process to cut down the trees, but the man is cutting down the trees indiscriminately. For example, industrial development. At the same time, there is an illegal cutting down of trees too. So this is because of this denudation, She has died of her parents. That is, she has lost her parents. If you just observe this picture, you can able to understand, my dear students, because of the loss of forest and loss of cutting of the trees, so this is the thing is happening around. And after that, so anyhow, she has, you know, like gradually overcome from her depression. And one fine day, one particular day, as she used to come to her usual resting place, of course she used to go with the gugu to the other different places, she used to sit in a open air, and she used to have a wonderful time. Now when she used to come to her usual resting place, a gust of wind with a familiar smell blew. The familiar smell blew. What is that? The smell of a sandalwood trees. My dear students, if you just observe the place where the sandalwood trees are there, you can find a beautiful and a familiar and a wonderful smell over there, the smell of a tree is over there. So sandalwood andre gandhada mara, gandhada kattige makkale nimge gotirutte gandhada marada ondu parimala ella kade yav rite irutte anta. So now here I also noticed that my friend, that is bird friend, was silent too, and I called out, but there was no answer, and she sat down and tried to lean against the tree. Then I realized there was no tree at all, just there was a short stump. Just observe the picture, stump, and then ondu maravanna kadada nantara ulidirthakkanta chikka bhagavanna stump anta kareethivi. Now she understood that many number of sandalwood trees have been cut down. She could able to smell, she could able to get the smell when the trees have been cut down. Now she come to know that sandalwood, I thought, oh my God, sandalwood trees have been cut down. I walked and found three more such stumps, three more sandalwood trees have been cut down. Then immediately she went home and told to the Rao Garu, uncle, what happened? The sandalwood trees have been cut down. Some sandalwood trees have been cut down. Then immediately the answer, I must check with Mudaliar. Mudaliar is the head constable at the village police station. Yes, when Sunanda came back and approached Rao Garu saying that many sandalwood trees have been cut down, immediately Rao Garu said, I must check with Mudaliar. Said Rao Garu, that is, Mudaliar was the head constable at the village police station. The next day I had a fresh news again for Rao Garu saying that, uncle, still many more sandalwood trees have been cut down. Now Rao Garu said confidently, the sandalwood trees are well protected, Sunanda, no one can break a single twig. Then she was convinced with the answer of her headmaster, that is Rao Garu. She was quiet, anyway might be it has been protected, like that she felt. But again there was an incident, the incident in the next following night. The next following night I quietly slipped out of the house. Gugu along with her reached the sandalwood trees. I heard low whirring and low sound voice. What is that? Just see the sentence and observe it. The voice is something like this: enough for today, Ramesh, it's 2 o'clock, and remember, 10% of your money you earn by selling this sandalwood is mine. Let me repeat the word there. This is the voice heard by Sunanda in the next following night when she had to the usual resting place there. She has heard the voice saying that, enough for today, Ramesh, it's 2 o'clock, and remember, 10% of the money you earn by selling this sandalwood tree is mine. Otherwise, the authorities would be arrested, alerted, and you would be behind the bars for the rest of your life. When Sunanda heard these words, she was shocked. So now she has come to know that, one of the person is also involved in cutting down the trees. Who is that? Now she come to know that, my heart skipped a beat for the voice that she has heard was that of Mudaliar. Mudaliar was a, yes, he was a head constable at the village police station. Even the head constable at the village police station is also involved in cutting down these sandalwood trees. Now she was surprised. Now she became very brave. What is that? She held her breath, gripping Gugu's collar, and immediately she moved away from that place. Of course, sir, the replied another voice. As soon as all was quiet, I rushed back home and quietly go into the bed. So this is what the incident that has happened in the following night. Immediately in the morning, what the girl Sunanda did is that, in the morning, as soon as Rav Gaur was awake, I told him everything. What is that everything? The 10% of the amount that the Mudaliri is going to get, because the sandalwood trees have been cut down, all the thing that she has heard before, she has informed to the headmaster Rav Garu. Then I must take up this to the police headquarters, that is at Uttakamandu. So now, after a few days, I was called to the police headquarters with Rav Garu there, and several questions have been asked. On the way home, she asked Rav Garu what would be the position of Mudaliar. The Rav Garu said, of course, he has did a mistake. It is a crime. So obviously, he will be arrested. After that, a month later, one morning, Rav Garu took my hand in his and said, warmly, my dear Sunanda, you had been given a reward. By whom? By the police department. Since you have helped them to unravel the sandalwood racket. She has helped the police and headquarters that she helped them to find out those thieves who are cutting down the trees. That too, sandalwood trees. So what is more, said Rav Garu, I have decided to admit Sunanda in the National School for Blind. This is what the thing we need to understand. Though she is blind, my dear students, she stood bravely. She stood bravely in order to stop to cut the sandalwood trees. Of course, she has been rewarded by the police department. It will help you to get a good start in your life. At last, she said, I wanted to thank Rav Garu because there were no words for me to say. She felt happy. Of course, she has been rewarded by the police department. So with that, we will conclude this particular lesson, that is sandalwood trees. Now I ask you people to observe the home assignment. There are some 5 to 6 questions. Quickly let me read out. Where did Sunanda live? Who looked after Sunanda when she lost her parents? Why are the trees cut down by man? And why did Sunanda hear in the forest at night? And why did Sunanda have to go to Uttakamandu? And where did Rav Garu want to admit Sunanda at last? So now I request you to just go through the textbook and find the answer for all these questions, so that we will discuss the answer in my next session. Okay? Thank you so much, everyone. This is Mr. Rehman Ali, working as an English teacher, Government Higher Primary School, Budgumpa, Koppal District, Koppal Taluk. Thank you.
Anudina, anukshana, maniyellu kaliyona, kalikeya hosa hadiyali, jotegudi hecheya hakona, santasadi kaliyona, amma henbiyai classinali.
Yes, sir.
Yes, teacher.
The same, ma'am.